And now for our feature presentation.
Chewing. Oh, exactly. yard here.
Looks like a stable, Sterling.
Yeah, and a mighty sterling stable it is. Looks like some kind of big house made out of, like, popsicle sticks.
Hey, Gramps, does this stable get cable? May I help you?
Yeah, you can help us, Toots. Who's leading goose around here? Oh, great. There you go. Careful, careful, fragile. So we're Sterling and Stella. We're the king's horses.
The king has two horses?
The king's got like 50 horses, Skippy. Our regiment's just passing through on their way to the big celebration at the palace, and all the other barns and stables were full, so they shipped us over here for the night.
Well, yeah, lucky us. Do you have a reservation?
Reservation?
Excuse us?
Maybe you didn't hear us correctly, Senorita Honka. We're the king's horses. We got reservations wherever we wants to have them, Linda. I think I'm reserving me a spot right about here.
Hey, that's my bed.
Yeah, well, I hope that any goat fleas, Pops.
Goat fleas? Goat fleas? What's he mean by that, huh?
Yo, camel. It looks to me like you're sleeping in my spot.
Oh, contrary horses, I'm wide awake in your spot.
Hey, move it, you humpback, or else.
Listen, you can't just barge in here and start bullying the other animals about.
Is that so?
Yes, that's so. We are a very orderly stable where we reserve and respect the rights of others. And what are you doing?
Oh, me? I'm just getting ready to play my favorite barnyard game.
What, pray tell, might that be?
It's called Duck Goose. I said Duck Goose.
Yeah. I got it. Pause! Can you believe those king's horses? Do you think they need some better manners? I think so, too. Fortunately for Mabel, a hero is about to show up and save her. And do you know who that hero is? Yup, Pa's right. You know her, you love her, you bought all her albums. It's the one, the only, Sammy Larry.
Hey, where does she come from?
It's Sammy Larry. She like appeared out of nowhere, Sterling.
Baby.
Oh. Baby. Oh, she's singing a love song.
No, baby, out there. Oh my goodness, she found a baby out there. We must save it. Not everyone, to the baby! No, lady with the baby. Lady gonna have a baby.
You're gonna have a baby, Sammy?
Boil some water!
Tear some sheets!
Take the nursery!
No, I'm not having a baby, you know, schools. Look, I was out running with the 4th Street block, you see? And they tell me about this woman and her husband who are on their way to town, right? And they say she's going to have a baby any minute, you know? And get this, are you ready? The baby that she's going to have is going to be the king. The king? She's gonna have a baby, and the baby's gonna be king?
Whoa. What's all this talk about some baby, and the baby's gonna be king?
Yeah, we already got a king, and he ain't no baby.
Well, apparently this is supposed to be the real king. I've checked all my sources on this one, guys. My mother's brother Frankie, Fluffy Joe down at the city gate, old Tom Pants over at the temple stable, they all swear it's true. Apparently, you ain't never seen a king like the king this kid's gonna be. Oh my goodness, how exciting!
A new king? Wow.
Right on.
Hold on. Just a minute here. We're the king's horses.
Right.
And ain't nobody told us about some new king baby.
Got that right.
As the king's horses, we'd be the first to know if a new king was coming.
Word.
So you know what I say? I say, anybody talking about some new king is being disloyal to the real king. Anybody going around talking about this king baby, anybody doing that ought to be in really, really big trouble. And that includes you, buddy.
Don't call me buddy, I mean you.
What'd you say to me?
I said I mean you.
You're a me.
No, I'm a you. You as a female sheep.
Oh, now as a female sheep?
No, you as a female sheep.
No, I is not. And I'm saying I isn't.
Look, try to get this. I'm a you.
You're a him?
No, you.
I'm a him?
Make up your mind, man.
These guys are denser than Mabel's meatball.
Look, try and connect the dots here, okay? The female sheep is called a you. She is a female sheep. She is a you.
Okay, she is not a me. And the next one you that says so is really gonna get it.
He is a he, I am a me, and you are a you.
That's what I'm saying.
Then say
I it. Did, isn't that what I said?
All right, enough of this nonsense. I can't take it anymore. We have more pressing matters. A new king is about to be born.
Yeah, Mabel's right. Where's the king gonna be born, Sammy?
Well, that's what I was starting to tell you before Mr. and Mrs. Horsefeathers here butted in. The man and the woman are looking for a place here in town to stay. But get this, there is no place. I've checked all the inns and hotels, and they're all full.
All of them?
Every last one.
But they're gonna get here, and they're gonna be looking for a place, and they're not gonna find one.
Then where's the king baby gonna be born?
Out in the cold street?
Or out in the desolate desert?
It's a catastrophe!
Yeah. Innkeeper doesn't have any room?
He's booked full.
Well, I say we go into that inn, draw out some king soldiers to make some room.
Hey, you just try it, old coat.
Okay, simmer down now. Nobody's gonna be throwing anybody out of the hotel.
Got that right. Listen to the goose.
Instead, we're gonna make a place for that baby right here.
A king born in a stable, Mabel?
Who ever heard of such nonsense?
I think this goosey's a little loosey in the head, if you know what I'm saying.
Our stable may be humble, but we can make it warm. We can provide food like milk and eggs and take the hay and make it as comfortable as possible.
Oh, comfortable? Yeah, me. The kid would be more comfortable sleeping out in the street.
Got that right.
Well, the street is where our new little king is going to end up if somebody doesn't take initiative and do something.
Okay, we're going to
go. I'll show you initiative.
This arguing part kind of went on for a long time. Some of the animals wanted to welcome the new king, and some didn't. It's probably best if we just fast forward a little bit. 3, 2, 1.
all of you. Even though I'm just a loosey-goosey, and even though we're just a bunch of lowly animals, and even though people don't even think we're needed or, I mean, even important, and even though people may think we're dirty or stupid or insignificant, we have a chance here. Don't you see? We have a chance to receive a king, make our humble stable, and make it like as worthy as a king as possible. It's the chance of a lifetime, and right now, we're the ones who can do it. No one else. So what do you say? What do you say? Should we make our stable ready for the king? All right, then, let's do it.
Let's do it.
My God, let's do it like it's never been done.
We'll make a place for the baby right here in the room.
Indeed we shall. Operation Hey Baby is underway.
Hey Baby?
Don't you try to Hey Baby me, pal.
My sternum.
So that's how we decided that our little stable house, silly as it seemed, was going to be a place to welcome the new king. We didn't have much time. I mean, the new king could be here any minute. So Mabel got us decorating and cleaning and cleaning and decorating and getting everything ready at high speed. It was a big job. It's hard to do a quality stable on a modest budget these days, but we tried. All right, then. We'll hang the ark on the chicken stand over there.
Chicken ark, got it.
And we'll create sort of like a sitting area in the back for the mother. Something with some soft blues, white kinks, very relaxing.
Like that'll be the perfect place for the espresso machine.
Yes, exactly. The express... Oh, Narcan, that's ridiculous.
Would you go for food with us?
It is ridiculous. Yes, he knows full well we can't afford an espresso machine.
Would you go for some smoothies?
Goodness gracious, what is that? What do you mean, what? It's a lamp.
Brilliant idea, Grant. Where are you going to plug it in? Electricity hasn't been invented yet.
It's for different purposes, pony boy. Cam, what on earth?
Beanbag chair. Everybody loves a beanbag chair. Beanbag chairs are for me, man. Every little king should have one.
I'm not sure it'll go with the decor.
Hey!
Look, guys. No crib for a bed, no problem. You just put a little hay in the feeding manger and presto, a resting place fit for a king.
You want the baby king to sleep in there?
That's a good one. You're gonna let your little king sleep in a feeding trough? I sure hope your goat doesn't get hungry in the middle of the night, or he might nibble the little guy's toes off.
You two just need a shush now.
Hey, if you ask me, you'd be better off just plucking this goose to make a nice feather mattress for the kid.
Now that's something I'd be willing to help with. Maybe we should just set the decorating aside for now and work on something else. Oh, I have an idea. Line up, everybody. It's time to practice manners and etiquette.
Etiquette? What? Etiquette?
Oh, is etiquette the same thing as an udder?
What do you can't get milk out of an etiquette, you dense donkey.
Well, maybe if you tried hard enough.
Etiquette means proper and accepted standards of behavior. For example, when the new baby king comes in, it'd be proper etiquette to bow.
No problem.
I meant bow humbly. What's the point of that? Lowering yourself before the king to show proper respect. When you bow like you just did, you're only glorifying yourself.
These guys wouldn't last one day in the court of a real king.
Mm-hmm. Let's try something else. Let's say the king's father walks in and puts the new baby king right in your arms. You actually get the chance to carry him wherever you go.
That would never happen.
How do you carry him?
I don't know. By the neck, maybe?
Maybe football style.
No, you make him stand up and walk like a man.
Listen up. The proper way to carry the new baby king is with utmost reverence and respect.
Oh, and etiquette.
You watch every step you take
talking about the king here.
You're talking about a joke is what you're talking about, Goose.
Got that right.
If there really is some baby out there, which I doubt, he ain't no real king. And if for some reason his parents wanted to bring him to this weird little stable, which is ridiculous, that just proves he ain't a real king. Because ain't no real king coming to stay in some dirty, tiny, insignificant stable full of a bunch of foolish, funny barnyard animals who take their orders from a goose. You guys are dreaming. Tomorrow, when our regiment comes back, we'll show you what a real king looks like.
Yeah. Ben's gotta be the most highfalutin horses I ever met. I heard him get saddle sores.
Excuse me. Mabel, I think I need a counseling moment here. I think that maybe the king's horses might be right, you know?
Now, Molly.
Well, I mean, look at them. They're so pretty and proper, and they know what a real king's supposed to look like. Now, what do I know? I'm just a dumb mule. I'm not even a good mule. I'm not even stubborn.
Yes, you are.
Okay, I am. Don't agree with her. Be stubborn.
Aw, see? I told you. I'm just a pushover. I'm just an ugly, dumb, unstubborn pushover. And the king's horses are so pretty and beautiful.
Horses. Yeah.
Bless it.
Molly, chin up. You may not be as smart or as beautiful as the king's horses, but you've got something that they don't, and we all know what that is.
No, we don't. Not a clue.
She says the horses definitely. Oh, stop it now. Molly has heart, guts, grit, character.
She does?
I do?
Of course you do. We all do. And that heart is something that those proud, pretty horses wouldn't know a thing about. Any king who's a good king is going to recognize that heart, Molly, and he's going to love it. You just wait and see.
Come on, Molly, I'll get you an espresso.
Stella, these barnyard bones are driving me crazy. Oh, he's talking about lady with the baby. No king. Make ready for the king.
I blame the goose myself.
Yeah, Mabel. Mabel in her crazy stables, more like it. Look at this place.
Yeah, if I were a baby king, I'd definitely hang out here.
There is no baby king, Stella.
Right, I know that.
You know what? As the king's horses, we shouldn't be putting up with all this.
Yeah.
If we was any kind of respectable king's horses, we'd stand up and say, there's only one real king, and this kid ain't it.
Amen.
If we was any kind of respectable king's horses, horses who love their king, who adored the one that ruled over us, horses that had even an ounce of dignity, courage, respect, or righteousness, we'd steal all this stuff and make sure that little party never, ever happens.
Yeah. Did you say stealing?
Yes, I did.
Like all the furniture and decorations, like the take it?
That's what I'm talking about.
We don't want to be stealing, Sterling. Stealing is wrong.
But Stella, we're the king's horses. That means we gotta protect the king if anybody tries to say they're king, right?
Yeah, but...
Then you get the lamp and the beanbag chair. I'll take care of these decorations.
Can you believe these guys? They're supposed to be the king's horses, and they're stealing. But I don't think they're gonna get away with it. Do you? Because we know some things that they don't know. Like, for instance, there's a big, huge camel just around the corner.
How's it going?
You!
No, I'm a camel. Send me over there. She's a huge.
She's a me?
Don't try and change the subject.
No! You!
No. Camel. 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 You. You. Camel.
Me? Camel?
Did he just call you a camel? Did you just call her a camel?
You!
Right here. No, no, not you. You, him, you. You!
And you!
All of yous! What are y'all doing with our decorations for the king? Stealing it. His idea.
I tried.
You!
Right here.
Yeah, we're stealing him. Look, as the king's horses, we're through putting up with this stuff. So we're taking all these decorations, and there ain't nothing yous can do about it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, you're probably right anyways.
You ain't going nowhere, you varmint Snyder. Drop that beanbag in that lamp, or you're gonna force us to take them from you.
You?
Right here.
What? No, I mean, you think you're gonna take this stuff from us?
I don't think it. I know it, you puny pony.
Whoa, isn't that impressive?
She goes crazy. Let's get out of here.
Away in a manger, no crib for a babe. a couple thousand years when he can actually plug in.
You there, little one.
Me?
Yes.
Come. No, you don't understand. I'm not like the king's horses. I'm ugly and dirty, and I shouldn't be by a king.
Come. Come closer.
Really?
Yes.
Hey, what's he doing?
He's reaching for you, Molly.
He's grabbing my hand. My hoof? My hand. He's actually grabbing my hand, Mabel.
Mm-hmm, I see.
He likes me better than the king's horses.
He knows your heart.
He does?
Yes,
and theirs. So that's how it happened in Mabel's stable. Mabel and Molly and the others made a decision to prepare a place for the king, and that's why the king came. The baby's mother named him Jesus, and after all these years, he's still the king.
Love would cost. He made a way.
just wanted to share briefly, before we conclude today, a couple of things about the manger. Our kids did incredible, sang so well. Thank you to all that took time. But we all know the real reason we're here today is because of what Christ did. He was willing to step from heaven to the earth for us. Amen? And just a couple of quick takeaways that I want us to be able to hold in our hearts. First of all, the manger was messy. Any of y'all ever been around animals? They don't always smell so fresh. Neither do teenagers sometimes. But we see all of these decorative manger scenes, and I think sometimes it paints an inaccurate picture. That Christ wasn't born into a palace. He came into a dirty place. A place that nobody really wanted to go to be. Not even intended for humans. The second thing that I want you to remember is that Jesus wasn't born into a perfect family. His mother Mary was only about 14 years old when she became with child from the Lord. I'm sorry, can you imagine explaining that to your soon-to-be husband? They had not even been married yet, telling him, I'm pregnant, and God did it. It's tough to explain. And think of how their neighbors, how the people that knew them must have wondered, because the angel didn't appear to them. Thankfully, the angel came to Joseph and explained, but other people would point and gossip and wonder, where did this child come from? Finally, the third thing is that even after Jesus came, even after he was born, his life was not easy. In fact, not long after he was born, they had to flee to Egypt because the king of that time, Herod, made a decree that all male children 2 years and under would be put to death because he wanted to stop this prophecy about the true king coming. I want to remind us of those things because there may be someone here today that you've never fully accepted Christ because you've never fully accepted yourself as good enough. Jesus didn't come for perfect people, perfect families, or palaces. He came for all of us, amen? How many of you remember where you were in life when Christ found you? We're all sinners saved by grace. And I also want to remind you that if you're going through a difficulty, don't give up on God. Just because Christ is in our heart does not mean life will be without its problems. But we know Christ was building up to something magnificent. Even though he had to go through the horrible tragedy of the crucifixion on the cross, it was ultimately to win the greatest battle, the greatest victory of all time. So whatever you're going through, if you will trust Jesus in your heart, in your life, I promise it won't be for no cause and no reason. God will be glorified. I would ask if you would to please bow your hearts with me. And I wanted to extend an invitation. If there's anyone here today that maybe this has spoken to you, where you say, I felt like the mule in the play, that I just wasn't good enough to even be around Christ. I pray for you that God will show you that he sent his son to die for you specifically. If nobody else would have made the decision to serve Christ, he would have done it for you. That's how important you are. You want to make a decision today to accept Jesus. You say, I'm so thankful for what he did, that he would come and die for me. Would you just lift your hand where you're at? I'd like to pray for you. Wow, anybody else? You can put your hands up. Several. I would encourage you as we pray today, if you commit your heart to Christ, get involved in the body of Christ. Get involved in church. I would love to speak with you personally if you'd see me after the program. If you'd like to be baptized, make a public declaration of your decision. That's what the Bible commands us to do. It encourages us to do. I also want to ask a second thing before we pray. If you're going through a difficulty, something in your family, in your life, and you just need God's help, would you raise your hand and say, I just need the Lord to help in a situation? Yeah, hands going up everywhere. Then I hope you're encouraged that even though when Jesus came to the earth and was born, all the problems of the world didn't go away. But he was on his way to the cross to make a difference for us. So I guarantee that Christ is working on your behalf, that the Lord is working all things together for good to those who love him, who are called according to his purpose. That's Scripture. Would you bow your hearts with me and let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, First of all, I pray with and for these who are making the decision, the biggest decision of all, to make you Lord and Savior. Thank you for these who are bold enough to raise their hands and declare, I want Jesus in my life. I want Him to be Lord of my life. God, we ask forgiveness of our sins. We confess that we've all made mistakes and have faults. And God, I pray that You would just give them the boldness and the knowledge that as they confess, they are forgiven. And that You're changing their heart right now in the name of Jesus. And Heavenly Father, I pray for all of my church family that would be going through a difficulty. Help us to trust You and lean on You. And realize while serving You doesn't make all the problems go away, it does make a way through the problems. So we trust You, God, and thank You. In Jesus' name I pray. And everyone said, amen. God bless you for being here. We've got one last song to do. Before we do it, I just wanted to say a quick debt of gratitude, a special thank you to some people. First of all, I would like to thank those that decorated our sanctuary, our church. That it just looks beautiful. It's so professional. Would you just show a debt of thanks to Sarah and Dakota Miller? They worked hard, long hours. Thank you. Thank you guys so much. I also want to say thank you to Judy and Ricky Ricks. They're just incredible what they can do. They built the stable for us, brought up here. Julie, I know, and Derek helped them set it up. Thank you guys. Would you show appreciation for them? Also to my good friends who are back there in the booth, Jimmy's running the camera for us today. Clinton Loggins is standing next to him. He ran light and sounds, helped us coordinate all sorts of stuff. And Miss Kathy Tucker, I have to say a special thanks to her. She was like my co-director, came to every practice, would fill in reading parts. She was also an understudy, so she knew the script very well. Then she even stepped up and ran the media. And y'all saw there was a lot that went into that. And they pulled it off flawlessly. Would you show your thanks to them? Thank you. I couldn't have accomplished this without my wife. She made the costumes for the kids. She came long hours, practiced with the kids' choir. She and Judy and Stephanie, those on Wednesdays that would have kids, would have them singing these songs and working on it. The kids did so great, but it wouldn't have been as good without these adult leaders. Thank you, Victoria. I love you. I appreciate all of you. We've got one last thing. This is kind of our grand finale, so hang with us. It's just a few minutes, and I'm going to introduce the cast to you during this. So if you want to cheer for them, you can. The kids are going to sing a little song, and then we're going to have them come out and take a bow. That'd be okay. Thank you again for being here. Let's go and tell it. Dancer, prancer, vixen, comic, cupid, donner, blitzen.
Yes, you won't know, that's so how
I'm supposed to say. In any kind of weather, even through the snow, know the reason for the season, ain't the globe is known.
Yeah,
looking much, much
higher,
higher, higher. Changed my life, and I gotta go tell.
2016, I'm without a
job. Made it to the mountains, is my routine.
Everybody's
known,
you know
I'm doing all good. Everest, one more time, put your hands together for our kids' choir. Awesome job, guys. And I would like to introduce the cast to you and show our appreciation for the long hours, a lot of memorization they put in. First off, she introduced the program to us tonight and got us started. You know her, you love her, you bought all of her albums. Would you give a round of applause to Victoria Hoffman as Sammy Lammy? And up next, a sweet lady is about to be a mother herself, stepped up and was married the mother of Jesus for us. Would you give a big round of applause to Vanessa Harrison as Mary? And then the person keeping us all stable while this all went on, let's show a round of applause for Reese Talbert as Mabel the Goose. And my partner in crime, one half of the Team Dolces, would you put your hands together and round of applause for Michaela O'Brien as Stella. And next up, she taught us such a valuable lesson at the end and did a wonderful job as Molly the Mule. Would you show appreciation to Cheyenne O'Brien as Molly? And one of our youngest cast members, you may not have known he was young because he was limping around like a little old guy. Put your hands together for Bishop Mimi as Gimpy the Goat. And he used to be my baby boy, now he's my big boy. And he's the big hulking camel that defended the stable. Would you put your hands together for my co-rapper, Mr. Noah Robertson? And of course I was Sterling. Thank you so much for being here today. God bless you.